Namaskar. A warm welcome to all of you. You all listen to my music, watch my videos on my YouTube channel. This video is a little different as I am going to talk to you about a particular topic. Before going directly to the topic, I would like to share with you a couple of incidences which led me to make this video. A few months ago, I had performed in a music festival in Pune. It was an evening concert and I had performed rag Gauri, which is one of the favorite ragas of Jaipur Atrauli Gharana singers. After the concert, I received a lot of positive feedback from the audience. But at the same time, many people told me that though Gauri is a beautiful rag, we don't get to listen to it much or we don't know much about it. The second incidence, just before lockdown, I had performed in a home concert in Delhi. It was a close, intimate concert with about 25-30 people in the audience. So I had chosen a few specific Jaipur Atrauli Gharana ragas, such as Sampurna Malkaus, Devsak, Lajwanti, etc. This concert was live on Facebook and many people listened to it online. A couple of days later, I received a phone call from Dr. Dinesh Thakur, who is the nephew of great Marathi writer Pu L Deshpande. While referring to Rag Lajwanti, he said, "Manjari, I have listened to this rag from Pandit Mallikarjun Mansurji when he used to come to Pune and used to stay with my uncle, and I cherish those memories forever. And I went back to those days when I listened to your Lajwanti." Abhijit, my husband, had recorded the whole concert. And when we were thinking of uploading some of the ragas from that concert on my YouTube channel, we uploaded Sampurna Malkaus immediately. But when we were thinking of uploading Lajwanti or Devsak, we were not sure, because we thought, would anybody search for the names of these ragas, or would anybody know about the names of these ragas? So it was like we were not uploading these ragas because we thought people might not know about it. And why people wouldn't search for the names of these ragas? Because they might not know about the ragas. So this cycle has to be stopped somewhere. And as an artist, I thought I need to do something about it. During the whole discussion, one more thought came to my mind that I have learnt so many beautiful ragas, beautiful compositions from my gurus. But how many of them do I actually perform? There might be different reasons for not singing them in concerts. It might be the time frame of the concert, might be the format of the concert, or even might be the type of the audience. So the point is, I perform very few ragas which I have learnt from my gurus. As all this discussion was going on, I remembered one more incident. A few years ago, I had performed in Yashwantrao Chavan Center, Mumbai. It was a Diwali concert, and so it was a morning concert, and I performed in the first session of that concert. As I was about to conclude and I stopped, someone from the audience asked me to sing rag Bahaduri Todi. I was short of time, so I just sang the bandish of Bahaduri Todi. When I remembered this incident, I thought that Bahaduri Todi is not a simple rag to understand, and it's also not sung very commonly, and still people asked me to sing that rag, which means that it might have reached them, they might have come across this rag somewhere and they must have liked it. And so they asked me to sing this Bahaduri Todi in that concert. When I correlated all these incidences, I realized if we as artists don't sing these ragas, these uncommon ragas, over the period of time, they will be forgotten. Instead, I thought I should take a small step forward to make the listeners acquainted with such uncommon ragas. With my such small effort, it would be great if the listeners could be able to enjoy these ragas more. And who knows, someday someone from the audience will ask me to sing those ragas. Because many times I come across people, I meet people and who always tell me that they are interested to know about the very special ragas of Jaipur Atrauli Gharana and as well as many other uncommon and beautiful ragas. That is why I am taking this initiative to introduce some of these uncommon ragas to all of you. I will explain the ragas one by one through individual video. At this point, I want to make it very clear that I am making this series only from the listener's point of view. So I request all the students of music that please, these videos should not be used as to learn any particular rag or any particular bandish, because these are not teaching videos or teaching sessions. I am fully aware and I strongly believe that such ragas cannot be learned with the help of such small introductory videos. Through this video, I have shared my thoughts with all of you. I want this video to reach maximum number of listeners and music lovers. So I request all of you to please share this video with your music loving friends. To get future videos in this series, please subscribe to my channel and click the bell button. Thank you.